So I can go in and pick all the edges.
You come here often?
Can you hear me?
Yeah. What's up? You painting?
Yeah.
Nice. Are you doing the streaming thing?
I am.
I did not know.
That's all good. We got rid of the channel that said I'm streaming. But I've been trying to do it just because it kind of forces me to sit here for an hour or two and paint. Still here? Are you muted yourself? Why did you mute yourself? Oh, well.
I don't know, it's weird. Like,
okay.
I don't know, when people stream, I don't really like to talk so that they can interact with whoever's actually watching.
There's nobody watching.
It's weird because I have to talk to you basically on your stream because it doesn't come through on Discord.
What doesn't come through on Discord? Oh, like your voice doesn't come through in the stream?
No, my voice does come on the stream, but your voice doesn't come on through Discord. It only comes on through the YouTube stream.
I got the wrong mic selected. It's gonna be a terrible mic. There you go.
Hey.
That's the headset mic. I can't get the good mic all the way over here.
Let's go, baby. Yeah, if you ever need new paints, just let me know.
What, have you given up?
It's been a while. I mean, if you can get use out of them, of course I'll just hand them over.
What are you talking?
It's
about?
It's a lot of paints.
He's got a brand new book. They got brand new units. This is your time.
Oh yeah, I have to look at the new Warcraft stuff, don't I? No Warhammer.
Almost bought a box.
A box of what?
Of Seraphon.
Oh my god, no. Why would you do that? They're little lizard people.
Yeah, the models look great.
The new ones look okay. Ooh, there's a limited edition battle tome. Just what I wanted. $90 for a book.
Well, if you pay $178, you'll get the book, you'll get some units.
Dude, the only thing I want to put together is that the frog on like the like the king frog, essentially, and he's holding like a scepter, and he's just like sitting down, and he's levitating.
Is it Croak or Slaan?
Slaan, I think. Slaan Starmaster.
Yeah. They have a new model for that.
Yeah, only $85 for some plastic, you're right.
I mean,
I say that, but I buy like cardboard way more expensive than $85.
It's like magic, yeah.
Yeah, it's so much more expensive.
Everybody has their own.
Yeah, that's true. Oh my god.
I will say, at least you don't have to paint the magic cards.
You're right, they come pre-painted.
That would be
sick. Thank god.
It's like, play magic, paint your cards.
You actually can. Like, there's... like, altering is completely legal in Magic.
Of course it is.
Yeah. It's so cool, though. Like, if you're a good painter, you can make a lot of money. New job for Becca and you.
I'm good. Can barely get my army on the table painted, so...
Wait, did the boys tell you I was thinking about investing into Pokemon cards?
No. They did not tell me.
Because it might be a mistake.
Whatever. We're moving on. I'm not gonna stress about it.
It looks good though.
This is my test piece.
You're testing out the color scheme or?
Yep.
Nice.
And if this one looks good, then I only have to paint 9 other ones. You know. As you do.
Yeah, we need to get you a Bellicore to paint.
No. I don't even own that army. Why would I paint that model?
It's because it's huge, dude. It's so big.
I still have my own massive models to paint. So, if I can get 10 of these guys painted and Vampire Lord and Zombie Dragon painted, then I will have a fully painted 2,000 points Soulblight army.
Is this for next weekend?
No, this is just for me. I've gotten tired of not having, like, at least one list of my army that's fully painted.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided to finish this one. As this is, as of now, I mean, it might change coming up, but as of this moment, it's one of the more competitive army lists.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a lot of the stuff for it already painted. But you know, somewhere in like my collection, I still have like 80 zombies and like Black Knights and Vampire Lords and like 20 Dire Wolves. Oh, Fen is dreaming. Can you hear?
Hear what?
Fen is dreaming.
I mean, your mic is still kind of wonky on Discord.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is it low or is it like...
It's like not picking up half the things that you're saying. But I can make it up via context clues.
Okay.
Like
it's, let's
it works
see
for
if
me.
Can fix it. Scrub stream.
Age of Sigmar tier list, April 2023. I'm ready.
Okay, how about now?
Yeah, you sound fine.
Much better?
Yeah.
Okay. Just had to adjust it for this mic, the input gain.
Seraphon's a C on this tier list? I don't know.
Is it Seraphon's a C?
Yeah.
Where are you looking at this tier list?
It's on YouTube.
What's
Wait, apparently this guy's a pro level Age of Sigmar player. Stuart Iron Gutsman McCowan. Okay, apparently Lumineth Rumlords, S tier.
S tier?
Yeah, Gloom Spits Grits or whatever the hell it's. Yeah, Cardron Overlords.
Okay, I believe.
And Disciples of Tezzan Niche.
I believe the Cardron Overlords. That army is ridiculous. They're like steampunk dwarves. You basically build it so like you just shoot your opponent off the table. They can't even actually play the game. It's kind of BM.
Yeah, those four are in S tier, and there's no God tier. You didn't put anything up there?
Where's Soulblight?
B
tier.
She doesn't have it on there.
What kind of tier list?
Oh, it's called something different. Could it be possibly be called something different? Or no?
No. Not unless you're looking at an outdated video.
No, this is 2023 of April.
Yeah.
There's something called a big wog. I don't know what the hell that is.
That's Auric Warclans. Does it Legion of Blood? Is that a thing on there now?
What's Nah, actually. Wait, this is about before the Seraphon, the new Seraphon book.
Oh, yeah, so. It's before the new Seraphon then. You gotta look up the Meta Watch. It's really what you gotta look at. Like the GW published Meta Watch article. And then they have a win percentage per army because they track all like their competitive events.
Really?
Yeah.
That's a lot of work.
So, like, whenever there's, like, an official, like, GT, like, all the data's compiled from around the world.
Mm-hmm.
And then they put in, like, this MetaWatch article, and it says, like, here are the armies that have played in, like, the last, I don't know, X number of months and, like, registered events.
Mm-hmm.
And here's the win percentage.
Wait. This is saying that the last Meta Watch. Oh, here we go. March 30th, April 6th. Last one was April 6th. Was the new tome out already?
I don't remember.
Let me look. I got you. April 19th. So it doesn't include the new Seraphon.
I feel like there was one before that, like, or even after that, like a newer one, like in May. There's not a May one.
No, not that I see. I want to look up just Meta Watch here.
And like their community, you have to go to like the Warhammer community site.
Yeah, I'm on the Warhammer YouTube page.
No. Like,
okay.
You go to like community Warhammer, and they have like news articles and like FAQ updates and stuff like that.
Got it.
Because depending on the stats, they'll also do like quarterly updates to armies where they'll be like, hey, like this army has an 80% win rate. We're going to increase your points. We're going to nerf you a little bit because you're making the game not fun for everybody else.
Got it. They balance it based off win rate.
Yeah. Or if like a certain rule that they like published originally and it's like getting too ridiculous, they're like, all right, we're gonna amend that. Like they did it for my army. There was these guys. I could, before they amended a certain rule, I can make them on a 2-up save. So that means they would like defend against attacks on a dice roll of 2 or higher. And you couldn't modify that. It was like, you couldn't make it any higher. So they made it so now it's on a 3-up instead of a 2-up, which is still, you know, really good. I'm not like upset about it, but.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I feel.
How dare you nerf my army?
Yeah, last actual Meta Watch was April 6th.
Okay.
Yeah, that's crazy.
What's the stats on that? Like, who's the highest winning?
On April 6th. Disciples of...
Cinch?
Cinch, Gloomspite Glitz, Flesh Eater Courts, and Karjan Overlords and Luminous Realm Lords.
They had like... like a 60 something percent win rate.
Yeah, Disciples had 60.
So I think their goal is to try to get every army as close to like
50
as possible.
Yeah. Seraphon 45%.
Which one?
Seraphon.
The 45%. Old Seraphon book was, yeah.
Stormcast Eternals, 47%.
I think Daughters of Cain is also pretty low.
49%, though. That's
Daughters of Cain?
Yeah, 49%.
Yeah, that's the army that Becca plays. Yeah. And every time I play against her, like, I could tell. It just feels underwhelming. I'm like, oh, God. It used to have a ridiculous win rate. It used to have, like, a 60-something percent win rate.
Really? And then they nerfed into the ground?
No, it was, like, when their book first got updated, before, like, other armies' books got updated.
Mm-hmm.
So compared to, like, the older books, it was really strong.
God.
But then they started updating every other army book, and they're just, like... There's not enough, like, competitive builds in that army. There's one build where you basically take the big, like, snake lady model, Marathi.
Mm-hmm.
And then you combine her with a bunch of shooting snakes, and you just basically try to shoot, but it just doesn't have the output that it used to. I don't know.
What, do you think the new Seraphon is strong or dog?
I haven't played against it, but I did see some stuff about it. It has the potential for a lot of shenanigans. Like a lot of spell casting, a lot of mortal wound output.
Mm-hmm.
So it's hard for me to tell. Like, I don't think my army's, you know, overpowered, but everybody says that Soul Blight's a little too strong right now. I do think we actually have a pretty high win percentage. Like, high enough that I anticipate in the next 2 weeks when the new General's Handbook comes out that there's going to be a points increase on my army. I think I'm going to make things more expensive.
Really? Okay.
Yeah, which sucks. Like, a unit of 5 of these idiots cost 230 points, man.
Really?
Yeah. That's a lot of points, bro. And you can't bring them back. Like, once they die, they die.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I don't know.
Dude, it's absolutely crazy. TikTok keeps giving me Lord of the Rings content because we watched
it. Overheard you watching the movies?
Yeah, dude. I swear.
We fucking knew it. You love Lord of the Rings.
You love it, don't you? You love Lord of the Rings.
100 years, Lord of the Rings. Yeah, I'm surprised this time back. I'm surprised, like, you came back. I'm surprised Hunter and Button stayed as long as they stayed.
Why were you? I said I would come back. What the hell?
I wasn't around for that.
Oh, okay.
I just figured after, like, the first movie, people would be like, all right, we've seen this before.
Yeah, I've seen the second movie, like, 5 times. Because back when it had come out, my family was traveling a lot, so TV screens were just filled with Lord of the Rings stuff when we were flying, and I was like, okay, whatever, we'll put it on. But they never had the first one. They only had the second and third.
Yeah, I feel like I've seen 2 hours a lot, too. It's just a battle for Helm's Deep.
Yeah.
Okay. I guess I'll wait off to do the final highlights on the armor, and then I'll... we're gonna go ahead and do... We'll paint the horse. Which is easy. He's black, so we just need to retouch up the black color. If I can find it.
You just throw on some What's it called?
Shit, where is it? Some non-oil?
Yeah, just some non-oil. Yeah, yeah. Oh no, it's raining. Of course.
I've actually lost my black paint.
What did you lose?
I lost my black paint. I had it around here somewhere.
Yo, do you want some do you want some Vallejo black paint?
I mean, oh, here it is. If you're not gonna use it, yeah, I'll take
okay.
it.
Okay. Okay. I'll bring it over whenever I see you guys next.
You have some,
or whenever you need it.
Do you have some AK interactive paint?
I don't.
Apparently ice yellow is the goat.
Real, but yellows are so hard. How do they,
I don't know. I see a lot of professional miniature painters like use ice yellow from AK interactive to like highlight everything, dude.
That's crazy.
It's like, is that a
that's,
blue?
I mean,
throw some ice yellow on that. That's your edge highlight. Is that a purple? Highlight with ice yellow. Love it. Ice yellow and sky blue. They use those colors all the time. Alright, here's where I mess up my metallic paint job. Oh shit, I watered this down too much. Oh well. Just letting you know that my mic is open. Hello, everybody. You can't see this beautiful boy, but he's so beautiful. Okay. She's talking about the dog, if you were able to hear her.
He's not Girl Scout.
Okay. You gonna get your hair done? Take a jacket, it's kind of raining. Okay. This is gonna take so much longer than I thought. Oh boy, oh boy. you looking through your paints?
Nice. No,
where's the clock?
I got lucky. I found all the colors.
Which colors?
So I got a Vallejo game color set, and it's all the, it's like 1 to 80.
Doesn't that cost like $300?
It was actually on sale because it was before their new formulation. It was their old formulation.
So it cost $200.
It was like 155.
You spent $155 on paint. You painted one Stormcast.
No, hold up. One Stormcast? That's slander. It was at least two Stormcasts. I'll have you know.
Which you didn't even use the Vallejo paint. You used Retributor Armor or whatever.
You're goddamn right I used Retributor Armor.
Did you ever paint that Jasmine mini that you 3D printed?
I did, actually.
Okay.
But unfortunately it had fallen because I had it on my desk because I was really proud of it, and it fell, the arm broke off.
Ugh.
What else had broken off? Her leg and part of the flying carpet.
That's brutal.
And I was like, okay, it's garbage now. I threw it away.
You're like, mini painting is a trap.
Yeah.
Ooh, that rain. Yeah, I should put together a video where, like, I mean, everybody has already done this, where, like, everybody gives their suggestions on, like, the stuff that you should first start out with. And, like, paints and tools. And I think, like, every mini painting channel has this.
Yeah. Here's some things I wish I knew when I was getting started. What else is there? Best painting technique for newbies.
Yeah, or like best paintbrushes. I will say that for the longest, the absolute longest time, this paintbrush right here, this super disgusting looking army painter, it's clearly seen a lot of love.
Yeah.
Right. And this came as part of like the paint set that I bought. I don't even think it's like a, I think it's a synthetic paintbrush. I don't even know if it's actual real hair. But this thing has been an absolute champion. It has done so many paint jobs. I mean, I finally stopped really using it for anything important just because the tip is all like messed up, and I obviously didn't take good care of it because I didn't know what the hell it was doing.
Yeah.
But total goat. Like, I would highly recommend that for anybody first starting out. And then I've been playing around with these two brands, the Raphael 8404 and mm-hmm. the Da Vinci Maestro. I'm actually really liking this one. I think I'm liking this one a lot more than this one. It's a little cheaper. This mm-hmm. is also, it's a really good brush, this one either way. But you can tell, like, this one's slightly longer. And it's got like a nice little spring to it. I don't know. So I've been using this one a lot. And I think I might buy another one. I like a size 1, maybe like another size 0. Just because I've been really, really enjoying it. Alright, let's actually... So I painted all the horse stuff black. I just touched it up again. And then I'm going to paint all this barding. And then the skull. Let's paint the skull. We'll try a color that I just got recently. If I can find it. Ah, there it is. XV88, baby. And we'll paint the skull and the hooves with this color. I'll put it here. Floor skulls with this too. We'll see. Hmm.
lottery than I thought it was gonna be. Just means we'll need to apply two thin coats. Screwed myself on this one here a little bit.
a second coat. Because we have to... The night Carl said, so cool. Hey, Melissa. Thank you, Carl. Just imagine, you could also have Blood Knights if you played Warhammer, Age of Sigmar. Start your army today. Find a friend nearby. Okay. I mean, Skaven is, you know, that's the way to do it. I bought a box of like 20 clan rats for a D&D game one time just because I needed were rats, and I was like, oh. Never used them. We never got to that encounter. So now I just own 20 clan rats. How's your Leviathan box coming? Have you painted any more of the pink Tyranids? Oh, the box comes in tomorrow. Wait, were you getting... Oh, these are just Tyranid models that you had from before the box? Okay. Are you gonna do another video? Like, I know there's a model in that box that has like a brain. And it's got like a brain on tentacles and stuff. Like, I think that one would be cool to do your pink scheme on. The Psycho Fate? That's a great name. It's taken a lot of self-control for me not to, like, order one of those boxes. On the Discord for the game store that I go play at, yesterday somebody was like, hey, who wants to go 50-50 on a Leviathan box? I just want the Space Marines. You can have the Tyranids. And I was like, it's like, I'm never going to play them, but I just want the model so I can paint one. Yeah, but I would be paying for it just so I can, like, paint the model and not actually, you know. You guys would have to teach me to play 40K. I mean, Chris picked up Sigmar pretty quickly. The few times that I played with him, from having played with you guys. So I feel like already having somewhat of, like, experience would make it a little easier. Yes. You should definitely get an AOS army. Just remember, all the AOS models can double for D&D models, so it's really like you're killing two birds with one purchase. They had a really good, they had a really good box come out during Christmas. It's like a Legion of Grief box set. If you can find that for under $200, I think that was a really good purchase. Because it just had a lot of stuff that you would use in a regular Nighthaunt army anyways. It had like Lady Olinder, which is like the big shrouded lady, and the Black Coach, which is one of the most insane looking models. Like the big ghost carriage thing. I had it on my wish list and I was going to buy it because I've been going back and forth about starting a Nighthaunt army or not. And then ultimately I decided not to because I had too much of unpainted soul blight, so I punished myself. It's like, you don't deserve this. You didn't paint your other army. No new army for you. Really excited to see the full Tyranid like mantis paint scheme. I think that's gonna be so cool on the table. Let's do. Yeah, I bought an airbrush, and there's definitely a learning curve to it. I total ass at using it. Like, I see everybody using it, they're just like, you know, they'll spray on there and it's like they'll get this light miss, and then they'll do a couple passes and you see this gradient begin to form and you're like, oh wow, that's so cool. I went on there, I'm like, yeah, airbrush, and it's just like shit all over the model, and I was like, all right. It's like, I ruined this. Awesome. I don't know which one you got, but I bought this one because everybody online raved about it. They said like it lasts for ever and ever, and it's a good all-purpose and Iwata Eclipse. But it's like developing like the control, I guess, to get the proper spray and stuff. It's so hard. At least for me, you might have a much easier time. I definitely require a ton more training on it because I am total ass. Okay, we gotta paint the leather on here. I don't know what color to make the leather. Yeah, in retrospect, I probably should have just, like, not spent hundreds of dollars on an airbrush to learn, but I'm not the smartest individual when it comes to my hobby. We just do things. I just realized I got paint all over this and I gotta repaint it. Ugh. Crap. Whatever. Okay. I need to figure out what color to make these straps here. So we are going to make them a dark leather color. So we'll go with not Rhinox hide. Where's the other one? The darker one. No, we'll go with Rhinox hide. So this is my test model. Basically trying to see how this color scheme goes, and if it goes okay, then I have to paint 9 more. And hopefully I remember what I'm doing. Well, I'm recording it, so I will remember what I'm doing. Yay for recordings. Feel about this color. Okay, I'm gonna hold off on this. I kind of don't like the brown. I'm not 100% sure where I'm going with this. Becca suggested this be a gray. This cloak. I'm tempted to make it red. And then she's gonna yell at me about it. I feel like a gray would just blend in too much with the armor on the horse. You think the gray would blend? Maybe brown? Maybe. I'm tempted to make it like that red gradient that I've done on all the other models, where it's not like this red, but like lighter red, because then they'll have like the, I don't know, the dark of the this, and then the this would make it pop. Shit, kind of stuck here. Let's do it. Let's do a test on it, and then if it looks like butts, then it looks like butts. All right, good luck filming. Bye. Let's do this first. I'm gonna call it here. Get some lunch. Thanks for stopping by, whoever did come by.